see some warming. Thank you for using your powers of meteorological magic. You know, what will happen now?
Indra does mean god of weather. Okay, Indra means god of weather, just so we all know, right?
Oh, that's how that translates.
God of power, god of weather. My parents are very, very smart. All right. Let's talk about the cold air. It is retreating out there. Maybe a little bit of snow, a little bit farther north. But overall, not bad. 1.5 inches of rain, temperatures 20 degrees above normal. Yes, you're welcome.
Thank you very much. It's a little warmer, so bring the good news.
Are we happy now? Are we
yes,
happy
please.
Yet? Okay. And it's only going to get better. That's the good news. We're looking at the jet stream lifting out. So things are improving. Notice that's what the temperatures were like yesterday. Now let's kind of step you up to what we're looking for as we get through the weekend. So much better. We're talking about temperatures in the mid-50s, even some 60s expected. But still, warm for everybody, and that is the takeaway.
Back to normal. It's quickly how we were so below normal and they so quickly back
gotta get,
to
like,
normal.
Hold that longer. So below
because
normal.
Because all
yes.
you think is brr.
You know what's also interesting is you watched.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
I and it did the other day tricky, when tricky. It was cold. You had a cold dress on, cold match, warm dress, warm.
Yeah, right? Mm-hmm.
How cool would it be if the dress became.
If you were green, it would be.
That's the next
I can
level.
Make it happen.
I think Andrew might have an issue with that one.
It would be very hard to point out areas on that.
Smart, Kate. Bit of icing around Arkansas and kind of moving in through Tennessee, but quickly fading, very weak out there. It's the system behind it that we're focusing on. Keep in mind the high pressure that brought cold air, the backside of that brings southerly winds. I always talk about the winds Mets always do because that's where the air comes from the south over the Gulf. That means it's warm air. That is why we're warming up. In combination with the low that's moving in, even though it's a cold front, we're seeing those winds coming out of the south. So between the two, warming up significantly, but of course here comes the rain as well. So by Friday, we are going to be talking about chances for showers into the Midwest, spreading into Saturday in towards the northeast. Sunday, yeah, there's a cold front, but about a 10 degree temperature drop. Not going to be the big story here. Just keep in mind that first system will bring a little bit of icing since it's still kind of mild. The second system, of course, will be bringing all rain. So I know you guys are looking forward to my science lesson. That is coming up next. I'll give you all the deets on solar flares.
Take
or you
notes.
Can study up, you know.
And quizzing. That is called a very good tease.
Yep.
Our favorite Met. Here on
look at the lingo set. That I passed on. I like this. So their weather pattern is changing. Our weather pattern is changing. Our temperatures are going up. You can actually see that cold air retreating back to the poles. So still below normal the farther north you are, but down to the south today, seeing average temperatures. And from here on out, it gets better because that warm air is making its way farther to the north. So temperatures will start to go from not only average, but actually to above normal for this time of year. What a gift after last week. I mean, notice DC looking for temperatures a good 20 degrees above normal by Saturday in the 60s. For January. Key point being, it is warmer, warmer, and say it again, warmer.
That's all I heard. All of that
all
science,
hear,
all I heard
really.
Was warmer.
I'm just gonna write warmer next time on the map and be done.
Just hold up a sign.
Finito.
Coffee break.
With the good stuff. This is my good stuff for the day. I'm stealing it, Chris. We're talking about temperatures warming up significantly. Pay attention, like Minneapolis, 4 degrees yesterday, New York City, below freezing, 22. Something up, I tweeted you guys this yesterday. A little payback for all the hazing I've had around here. Notice there is...
You two are away, and you were in the field.
You're out, take guys. It back. You and I are good.
Guys, not a competition.
Above, Kate.
But to
above.
The extent that it is, yes,
you there, buddy.
In the cold.
And... I don't really have anything to tell.
Been having some coffee in the lodge at the fireplace, Kate. I don't think so.
I was setting myself up.
I'm sitting at the ice desk, and I'm not going to wear all 19 layers that you
as
have
said,
on with those goofy
deal is
boots.
Agreed.
I will be in full gear. You will wear shorts at the ice desk.
Gear.
Good idea.
Did you just say Met? Is Met like some kind of sport term?
That would be
the latest.
Absolutely. So Indra promised to come back and tell us about these super cool.
Yes.
So,
Science lesson. First, we got to show the video, right? Let's take a look at the video first and look at this. This is a solar flare that happened 2 days ago, but the effects are going to be happening today. So we're going to show you the basics first. Let's first talk about what is a sunspot. So sunspot, that's a large area of magnetic, I'm going to say that slowly, activity on the sun. Okay, so we got this. Mm-hmm. Now, if there's an imbalance, we get something called a solar flare. Voila. When you look at this corner right here, that's like billions of particles of radiation, a scary word, coming towards the Earth. Takes 2 days. So that was 2 days ago. Today's the lucky day. So today and tomorrow, we're dealing with this. The most important thing you need to know, it does not affect humans. So that's the good side of this. But love those cell phones, GPS apps. It will affect that. We're also going to be talking about airline routes. So the farther north you are, they don't want communications affected. It's not going to affect the planes themselves. Mm-hmm. They're going to be flying lower for the next several days. So they're worried about that. Also, the delivery that was supposed to go to the space station, not going for this reason. But you can actually see it. That's what's pretty cool. So the farther north you are, Seattle, Chicago, Boston, you do have the chance to see the aurora from this. But again, the most important thing, it does not affect humans. A lot of people are worried.
Ms. Peterson's next class, can we learn out?